Trust the day, Monday, Monday, sometimes it just turns out that way. Oh, Monday morning, you gave me no warning of what was to be. Oh, Monday, Monday, how could you leave and not take comes, you can find me crying all of the time. Monday, Monday, so good to me. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be. Oh, Monday morning, Monday morning, couldn't guarantee that.
Of course, Monday, Monday by the Mamas and the Papas. Back from 1966, I think, though that's a long time ago, even before I was born. But still a really great song. Very nice to, you know, to sing together and to play. Even though playing-wise on guitar, it does have a few challenges. So, I was earlier with the capo, I mean, on the first fret, which is what they are as well if you watch the Monterey Festival performance. But in, well, the original recording, it would be here on the second. Everything is, of course, relative to the capo, for that matter. Now, from there, there are quite a few twists and turns throughout the progression. It starts in what you could call the key of E, but it immediately steps out of it. So you start on E, you already move to a D, and then it moves to a G. He actually bars it, and then he would play, well, like the melody notes that the girls are singing. Yes, like so. So starting on the 5th, to the 6th, to the major 7, and so on. I find it really easier to play it here. The 5th, then you have the E on top there, the 6th, the major 7, and back to the 6th. So it's something you could, you know, leave out if you want to, but it is, well, nice to have in there. And it moves to a B7, coming back to E. What you could have seen earlier, this is an E dominant 7 sus 4, and that's actually how he starts out the song as well, going back and forth between E and E sus 4. Yes, you do have to cramp all your fingers in the same fret there, which is the reason why I'm kind of moving up and down in in the fret itself. Let me see, what else is in there? At one point, yes, when you get to, well, what I call the bridge, the every other day, you move to, all of a sudden, to F. So there you have the first bar chord of the song. Yes, you could go for a little one, but it's, well, at one point you have to. So F it is, to a D, whatever else. And then it moves to a C sharp, dominant 7. I think he mostly plays it like this, maybe sometimes like so. This is chord 5 of the key you're going to, because we are actually moving up a whole step, well, raising it up with a whole step. So all of a sudden, when we started out with E, now we start out with F sharp and actually start over again with lyrically speaking as well. And then you also have this moving back and forth between major and the sus 4. And in this case, you also have a dominant 7 because you're leaving, well, the note on the 4th string in the bar because you're taking off your little finger. Whoa, oh. details. And that's indeed how he does it. Let me see whatever else. Then, yes, at one point you have, it turns to A, to the 6th here, to the major 7 there, and back to the 6th. And he does it the same way as he does with G. Like so. At one point there is, yes, okay, I think I got most of those chords. I mentioned the E7 sus 4, he simply just moves over to this one, so the dominant 7 is in the bass then. So all those details, if it's already way over your head, I discuss them in close-up thoroughly in the lesson. As for the strumming, that one is actually pretty doable, especially how John Phillips does it. He simply plays this single time, or what is it, the speed of eights pattern. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Maybe, yeah, kind of like that. He just keeps it going all the time. Maybe at one point, every other, and so on. So he might, you know, double up his strumming just to anticipate the next part of the song. But that's pretty much all he does. But if you listen to the recording, though, you can hear this bounce. Well, in a lot of places, so. Down, 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 down really nice if you can get the hang of that, because those kind of bounces, you will bump into those in many songs, I guess, especially if you want to, you know, drive something up a little bit. Like I said, he doesn't necessarily does, but you do hear it on the recording. Well, I already mentioned that. So, this should be doable with or without the bounce. I break that down, of course, as well. Then, is there anything else? Well, if there is, you will have to check the lesson. I talk about everything that I... Well, talk about... I show you everything that I talked about in here. For both hands, we go through the progression and all that. And you should be able to have this in your repertoire. Anyway, so if you want all those details, like to learn a song, then check it out at totalguitars.com.